Hello and welcome everybody. Today I will introduce to you how to connect our remote I/O system PSS Universal 2 to an Allen-Bradley controller. To accomplish our goal, we need the software's PASconfig, which is the configuration software for the PSSu2, and Studio 5000, the programming software for the controller. When we are ready, we can begin with the configuration in PASconfig. First, we will create a project to configure the PSSu2 hardware that we are using. We have to select a project name. Then we also have to select the correct head module for Ethernet IP communication. Now we have to give a name to the selected head module. Afterwards, we have to select an IP address. Keep in mind to adjust the pins on the hardware itself, so you have the same IP address configured in the software and on the hardware. After clicking on Finish, you can see that the head module is already in the hardware configuration. Now we have to add the missing I/O modules. For our application, we need an EF8DI and an EF8DO. Now that our hardware configuration is complete, we can save and download the project. To download the failsafe part of the project, we need to enter a password. The casual password is PSSu in lowercase letters. After configuring the hardware of the remote I/O system, we will switch to the Studio 5000 software and create a new project there. We need to select the controller that we are using and give the project a name. The settings that you can see now don't need to be changed for our application. Now we have created a project, and you can see on the left side that the controller is already in the hardware configuration. However, we need to add another module, which is the Ethernet IP bridge. For that, we will type in the search bar EN2T and select the correct module. Now we once again have to give our device a name and an IP address. Also keep in mind to adjust the revision to the revision or firmware number that you can find on the module itself. So now we have added the bridge and we can add our remote I/O system to the configuration. For that, we have to go back to PASconfig and export the system configuration to a L5X file. For that, we select our target destination and press OK. Now we can import the L5X file as a new module to our hardware configuration. After we imported the system, double-click on the Ethernet safety module to open the settings of the module. We have to generate a safety network number so we can establish a communication between the two hardwares. The next step is to copy the number and paste it into the target unique identifier settings in PASconfig. The new settings will be automatically downloaded on the hardware. Then we need to import the PSSu2 properties in Studio 5000. we go to the safety properties of the module and enter FS checksum in the ID field in Studio 5000 and the date and time of the last download in the date and time fields in the Studio 5000 software. So now we have finished our configuration and we can go online. Click on Communications and select Who Active. You will get a list with all members connected to your network. Select the correct CPU and press Download. After downloading, you can see that the status is set to running. That means that there are no issues and your Ethernet IP communication is working. Now to test the communication, we will write a small program. We add one input and one output. Then we map the IOs to the hardware. And now we can download the project again. Now we can see in the software when I put a high signal on the input, there will be a high signal at the output as well. Thank you for watching this video. For questions and more information, please write us an email at support@pilz.com. Have a nice day.